Hello viewers, welcome to our channel. In this tutorial, we would see a multiphase swirl flow simulation inside a pipe. There is a two-phase flow in a pipe. The pipe is under rotation around a 100 mm diameter, which results in a swirl motion of the fluid. Simulate this problem using ANSYS Fluent solver, without using any UDF. Let's know what would you learn from this tutorial. At first, you would learn about how to set up a multiphase VOF model in ANSYS Fluent. Then you would learn how to write the named expression for the swirl flow problem. Then we would demonstrate how to create a solution data export. Then we would see how could you retrieve the results data from the solution data exports, how to create an isosurface, and finally, we would create a solution animation video. For simplicity, let's start from the setup process. We have provided all the details of the geometry and meshing. If you still face any difficulties in that, then please comment, so that we could assist you. It is a cylindrical pipe geometry. The diameter of the pipe is 200 mm and it's extruded along the z-axis up to 1000 mm. The sweep meshing method has been used. The axisymmetric algorithm has been used to generate O-grid meshing with a number of divisions of 10. Additionally, adaptive sizing has been turned on with a resolution of 7 for a better refined meshed cell. The cylinder face, which is at the cylinder origin, has been named as the inlet. And the other side is named as the outlet. So, now let's start with the ANSYS Fluent solver setup process. Open the Fluent solver. Select the single precision model for a faster result with less accuracy. As it's a 3D multiphase flow problem, it would a long time to process the result. So the single precision model is used. Check the mesh first, make sure the minimum volume should not be negative. Check the quality of the generated mesh. Select the transient formulation. Go to the Add Materials menu, click on Fluent Database. Select the water liquid. Click on Copy, then Close. Now go to Models. Select the Volume of Fluid model. Select the Implicit formulation. Check the Implicit Body Force. Click on Apply. Now go to the Phase tab, select Primary Phase, name it as Air, and select the Air as the primary phase material. Then select the second phase and select Water as the phase material. Click on Apply. Close the Multiphase Modeling tab. Click on the Viscous model. Select the Laminar Viscous model. It would reduce the computational time. Now, go to Boundary Conditions. Select the Inlet Boundary. Click on Edit. Enter the inlet velocity as 0.001. Close it. Change the phase to water. Then go to inlet boundary condition. Select the volume fraction of water, and change it to 1. Which means we want only water to enter into the domain without any air. Now click on Outlet Boundary Surface. keep the default values. Click on Named Expressions. Right-click and select a new named expression. The pipe is experiencing a rotational motion along a circle of dia 100 mm. This motion can be represented as the two simple harmonic component. In the named expression, we are going to put the acceleration in x and in y axis direction to get the rotational effect on the fluid domain. Enter the name of the expression as x acceleration. In the description, enter the acceleration x direction. Similarly, enter the expression for acceleration along y-axis. Now go to operating conditions. In the x-acceleration gravity box, select the expression option. Select the name of the expression. In Y acceleration, select the second named expression. Go to Methods. Select the piezo method, it's recommended for multiphase VOF simulation. Go to initialization, select compute from all zones. Change the water volume fraction initial values to 0, which means the pipe is initially has no water in it. Then click on initialize. Now click on patch. Select the phase as water. Select the volume fraction as the variable, put the value as 0. Select the fluid domain as the zone to patch. Then click on patch. Also, this patching process is not required as we had already initialized the domain with 0 volume fraction. You can skip this process. But if you had not initialized with 0 volume fraction of water, then you should follow these steps. Now go to calculation activities. Here we would set the solver to save the desired output results file. In the automatic export box, click on create, select solution data export. In the automatic export panel, go to the third column quantities. Select the volume fraction of water as the output result file which is to be saved. Select the file location. Click on OK. Select the export interval. Now you can see the file in the automatic export table box. Now go to calculation. Enter the number of time steps as 500. Enter the time step size as 0.01. Now click on Calculate. It would take a long time to process the result. After the calculation got completed, go to the File menu and save the file. Close the Fluent and proceed for result output in ANSYS CFD post-processing. At first, we would create an ISO surface. For this, go to Insert menu. Select Location, select Isosurface. Select a variable as the water volume fraction. Put the value as 0. Then click on Apply. This is the view of water swirl flow inside the pipe in the time of 5 seconds. Open the time step selector, select the last time step. Now click on the animate time step icon. In the animation window, move the slider to the initial position. Select the file save location. Click on the option to modify the video file format and quality. Click on the play button to record the animation. After the animation got completed, go to the saved folder and play the animation. Use this for any future presentation. You would get such type of animation video file after it. With this, let's conclude the demonstration. If you had liked this video, then please hit the like button. If you are new to our channel, then please subscribe. Comment below for any suggestions or queries. Thank you. Stay healthy, stay safe.